Welcome back to Flinders Park, and welcome to our Wimbledon champion, Pat Cash.
Thanks, Shane. Hello, there I am. Big match tonight, mate.
There's a sort of an atmosphere as if it was a heavyweight prize fight, and they are really a couple of heavyweights out there, there's no doubt about it. Big hitters, and there is an air of expectation that wasn't here necessarily last night, and yet the match delivered a match and a half.
Yeah, I think, I mean, last night's match was just unbelievable tennis. Now, there is an expectation for Mark Philippoussis to do as well as he did the US Open, and let's hope he can, and better.
He won the toss, and he chose to serve. It's one of the great things about Mark Philippoussis, no signs of nerves, hesitation, really went for the second serve on the opening point. An air of confidence.
Yeah, I think we'll see him doing a lot of that, going for his second serve. That's his style, is flat out the whole way, going for everything.
13.
Well, that is... That's more than confidence. That's 175 kilometre per hour second serve. He's down the centre. See, Sampras had moved in. He might choose to move back a little bit. Well, remember a young player making a similar start in Davis Cup match against Britain some years ago. An immaculate start for Mark Philippoussis. One love without the loss of a point.
Welcome back, and that young man that John was referring to against Great Britain was Pat Cash, who's sitting right alongside of us. Pat, that's a great start for Mark, isn't it?
Oh, yeah, I mean, that's going to build his confidence a lot. We're going to see a lot of that. Mark Philippoussis is going flat out for his serves. He is going to be attacking the Sampras forehand, and a second serve we saw as an ace.
It's a little bit of chest beating down there at the moment, isn't there?
Yeah, well, this guy has got the smoothest, most relaxed serve I've ever seen. After you, of course. I've got to say, Jay, your serve was just about as relaxed and as smooth as his.
Yeah, he overruled it, yeah.
Just a little clarification there by Pete. Linesman had actually overruled the machine to begin with. Everybody on edge. Big hitting from the back of the court, but Mark matching it. Sampras goes for the line, just misses. Both players of Greek extraction. But thankfully for us, Mark's parents decided to come to Australia. There's Martin Mulligan, former great Australian player and Italian champion, and Mark's father, Nick, in the foreground, and Nick Bolitieri, the coach, behind.
That was a terrific backhand. He didn't have a lot of time there. He just used his strength completely.
And the reverse Blake angle.
Just pulled that around. That's just pure strength, really.
Oh.
Thank you. Advantage is Sampras.
It's a terrific first serve there into the forehand. Mark has got a very strong forehand. He's probably better when he has a chance from the back of the court.
Now let's have a look at these two great servers. Philippoussis with a decided height advantage. Weight goes back.
Watch the wrist snap. Bang.
Maybe a slightly more aggressive weight transference for Pete Sampras. Various debate on the advantage of height, but there is no debate on the advantage when serving. And Mark Philippoussis at 6'4", 1.94 metres, certainly has an advantage. Pete Sampras at 6'1", 1.85 metres.
6'1", I thought he was taller than that. It's amazing, isn't it? Speed you can get just from that wrist snap and the perfect timing on the serve.
14.
I think to a lot of competitors, he looks about 8 foot tall.
Yeah.
Certainly by the end of the match.
I think we'll see Mark Philippoussis doing a lot of those serves down the middle of Sampras's forehand. Don't think it's quite as solid off the returns, his forehand.
A bit of bad luck, the spin on the ball, reacting with the net to take the ball wide. You can see that it was actually online quite comfortably for a winner, but coming up and across the ball made the ball move sideways off the net. 40-30.
He's serving magnificently. His last three were 203, 204, 202. It's 2-1 opening set. Pete Sampras about to serve, opening set. Live action from Flinders Park. Mark Philippoussis has started strongly on both his service games.
Mark's play, that's his style. Gets that short forehand, he goes flat out for it. A lot of the time he's going to have to hit a clean winner from that. Otherwise Sampras is going to get it back.
30.
Well, the other thing is one of the most dangerous shots that Pete Sampras has is the running forehand when he rips it across court. So if Philippoussis goes down the line, and if Sampras gets there, he is very likely to clonk a winner back in return. But Sampras probably having an advantage in the agility stakes. So in close quarters, might have some distinct advantage. Mark moves very well for a person of his size.
Sampras.
And over the last few months, Pat, he's been working very hard physically with Todd Vining.
Yep, Todd, a Melbourne football player, Melbourne champion,
great athlete. Trains with the with Mark and the Victorian tennis.
Just thumping the forehand, approaching the net with a great deal of confidence. He only turned 19 in November.
13.
That's a giant serve. This sort of serving is going to give him a lot of confidence. If a guy can serve like this, he's certainly going to give him a good run. Sampras, a good run. It's going to fill him full of confidence. And when you're playing the world's number one player, is he's going to make a lot of returns, and that's why Mark's going to have to serve well. I think anybody who serves well is going to need to serve well.
Beautifully constructed. Super aggressive point. The serve at full power, the forehand from three-quarter court, and moving in, not taking any risk. That's one of the differences between the tennis he's playing now and a couple of years ago. In junior events, that forehand would have never come back, and he may have become complacent and not followed it up, but at this level, he has to follow up everything.
14.
Another attempted big second serve at 165. There's not been another player in the draw who's been serving a second serve that fast.
Well, if you serve that fast, you're going to serve some double faults.
Serve 166, and it came back with interest. Sampras taking the ball a meter inside the baseline, and he too following it up. The high defensive lob, the appropriate shot, just clearing the baseline. Philippoussis at deuce for the first time. Test for Mark. Break point down. Nick Bollettieri, a very good poker player. He never would allow a facial expression to change and maybe dishearten his pupil if he were to look up. Kicking second serve, a move to the net very, very quickly. Took the first volley a couple of metres inside the service line.
Facing a break point earlier. It's 3-2. Sampras to serve, opening set. Pat Cash, our special commentator, along with John Alexander.
15.
We were discussing in the break, J.A., that Mark Philippoussis just he does go for a lot. And you're saying, well, at 19, he's a very good player. I mean, this guy can match it with any of the guys as far as strength goes. If he can hit it hard, why not?
Yes, it is his natural game to go for shots. And that's where his future lies. And, of course, when you're going to go for shots, there's always the chance of having a bad day. And that's going to happen even if Mark becomes the world's top player. He will have the odd bad day. To win without risk is victory without glory.
Okay.
That's borrowed from Alan Jones, the famous rugby coach, has the odd good saying.
No, it makes sense to me.
Good sign for Philippoussis then. It did look out ball. Somebody called out, he just kept playing, didn't bother. Had a cursory glance down at the end. It's 15 Philippoussis, but 30-15 Sampras.
It's an amazingly high percentage of first serves from both players so far.
And Pat Sampras is winning 92% when he gets the ball in on a first serve.
Early tactic I've noticed from Sampras, which I find slightly unusual. He is attacking Philippoussis' forehand.
He's certainly on the serve, isn't he?
In the ground strokes, that's what I'm noticing. Yeah. I think he may be trying to open up the court to his backhand.
I think their mix of forehands and backhands are quite similar in that they both are capable of hitting great winners off their forehand, but I think their backhands are probably better, more versatile shots.
15.
Fifth ace for Philippoussis.
This one coming again down the centre. A switch up serve.
It's 210, by the way, just for the record. Just missing the line.
And Pete not happy with that. That was one of the easiest second serves he's faced, just down at 152. It did get up very high, but he almost snapped at it because it was going a little bit quicker, met it far too early.
Good return, that one. I mean, obviously the object for any player is to get the ball back in play, especially a guy serving that hard, but straight back down the middle there, no angle for Philippoussis to hit. Had to really get out of the way and didn't. I thought that was quite clever play from Mark there. Decided to go short just a little bit too high, I think. Sampras just clipping that across. The depth on that.
Mike Morris, he's certainly aware of Pete Sampras is questioning of the second serve.
Seven aces. It's a good way to hold your serve. 207 k's per hour, that one. Region Cam, Melbourne City. It's been one of those days, the four seasons in one. Government House, as we come into the tennis centre where the roof is on tonight. The sellout sign went up early for this one. New balls for Sampras, world number one. Against the 19-year-old Australian, games going with serve in the opening set.
Well, how quick does Mark move off the mark there to chase down the wide volley and then came back with a screaming forehand at the full run. Winning the first point just puts a little bit of pressure on Pete. Pete's success rate on the second serve is about 50%.
Well, there's nothing wrong with that approach shot. I'm talking in the last game about returns into the center of the court to give no angle, but Sampras got around very quickly here.
So maybe a couple of missed opportunities for Mark there, in that when you get a look at the Sampras second serve, it's a far better proposition than his first serve. He has a year average of 83% when the first serve goes in of success.
Talk about the rhythm of Pete Sampras' first serve. Obviously, it's a major part of his game. Watch the rhythm. Every time, it's the routines. Every time, it's the same thing. Gets that foot back, foot up there.
That was almost like a duck hook, that first serve. It went halfway up the net, if you're an optimist.
Sampras.
Well, let's get into the business end of the set. Mark has been holding on here with some incredible serves. He wants to try and keep that service percentage up. Seem really, it's a good return, good play, nice and deep, wait for the short ball. If you can hit it that hard, why not? Fantastic first serve, great return. What a great volley. See him hook that ball around, getting around the outside of the ball.
Thirteen.
14-15.
Good first serve in, slightly jamming Sampras there. Got a bit too close. Lifted up on the ball. She'll lift up here. Whoop. Just pushed it out.
Mark relies on the ball boys to give him his second ball. And he holds one ball when he's serving the first one.
So we were talking about earlier, Jay. If you open that court up there, for the cross-court ball, you've got to cover it quickly.
Yes, he really didn't follow up on that forehand. Had he moved to the net immediately, it would have been a far easier proposition.
Very tough thing to do, of course, when you've got Pete Sampras hitting passing shots at you, to feel confident about whacking the ball and running in.
Well done, Philippoussis. He holds. It's 5-4 opening set. 4-5 opening set. No breaks of serve to date.
Love 15. For serve.
Out, but it looked dangerous.
It was very, very dangerous. It's not the sort of shot you want to see flying past you. Love 15, trying to serving to stay in the set.
Angle again, the chip and charge off the second serve, and a little bit of luck on the backhand volley, just clipping the top of the net. It's going to be a winner in any case.
Two set points.
Great attacking play here. Hitting the ball, putting the pressure on the world number one. Make him come up with a big shot at the right time.
Well, Pete Sampras paying the penalty of not getting enough first serves in and leaving himself vulnerable to that attack.
White, please.
I think Sampras just realised a couple of things. The reality of Mark Philippoussis. He is playing one great player. He's playing against about 15,000 Australians.
Yeah. Yes, absolutely.
Thank you.
Second serve at 175 Ks. I don't think his confidence needed boosting, but I think the winning of the first set has brought Mark's confidence to a new height.
Serve
Oh, great pickup that was. He really had no chance of pulling it across unless he just flicked it with his wrist at the last minute. Watch his wrist here. Just pulling it across. Mark, could he have got that? He may.
Mark stayed flat-footed after hitting the forehand instead of moving in. Thought he had the winner.
13-15.
Kept at 207. This is third tonight.
Great champions come back, as we found out last night with the example of Jim Courier. And this is where Mark needs to really buckle down.
So in the crowd said, stop holding back, Mark. Pete Sampras is certainly having a problem with the pace, just the plain strength and pace of Philippoussis' serve there. Certainly taking his time getting used to it. Not quite wide enough.
Deuce.
Sampras just blocking this ball back. Well, a bit more of a block, wasn't it? A bit more than a block, but didn't have to go too far to get it. Very flat-footed there, Sampras, on that ball. Probably the easiest shot in the rally.
Thank you. Game, Philippoussis.
Philippoussis holds with another ace. Welcome back to our live coverage from Flinders Park. There's a fantastic atmosphere in here. No exaggeration. Roof closed, it seems to make it even more intimate. Packed house. Philippoussis has started quite brilliantly, and so, by the way, Sampras. He's played some wonderful tennis already, but he was broken in the 10th game of the opening set. And the young Australian leads by one set to love.
15.
As he did at the US Open last year when he won the first set in a tiebreak.
Well, I think, you know, he's got nothing to lose. I mean, I always felt when I was playing the top players, or one player in the world or whatever, is you've got nothing to lose. Why not go for these big shots, go for the big second serves and keep pounding the ball? If he's not... If Pete Sampras is number one in the world, he should be able to handle this stuff.
Again, Mark Philippoussis very quick off the mark.
Oh, he was there. Picked the side.
Accelerates very quickly.
You got 50-50 chance really then on those sort of shots. You really just got to make a guess and hope you guess the right side. Sometimes when your confidence is down, you're not playing well, you guess the wrong side all the time.
The Sampras serve, one of the most lethal weapons in the game.
What I'd like people to have a look at here is the wrist and elbow snap he gets after hitting the ball or just connecting there. That is all the snap. That is where he gets all the pace from. We'll have a look at Mark Philippoussis' serve later. It's slightly different.
From the back of the court. Absolutely amazing tonight. No way that one person could have covered both those shots. Pete looks for the call, and I think this is a show of tension for Pete Sampras. He has questioned several just close balls, and he normally doesn't question them unless they are very obvious errors.
I think it might have just touched the line. Therefore, it's in.
Everyone here thought it was in. But they're a little bit one-eyed at the moment. Good Australians, and rightly so.
Sampras is very tentative on those second serves, isn't he? Just wanted to get that back in play. He wants to start building his confidence up.
John Newcombe and Tony Roach, the captain and the coach of Australia's Davis Cup team, who've spent a lot of time over the past 12 months with Mark.
14.
The interesting statistics there are that Pete Sampras is more successful when he gets his first serve in. He's getting a couple of percentage points less of the first serves in. 83%, that is his annual average of success rate on first serves.
Very impressive, isn't he, Philippoussis? It's 2-1 in this, the second set.
Philippoussis leads 2-1.
Flinders Park Complex, the outside courts with the lights on, but nobody playing. The roof over the top of centre court. With Mark Philippoussis and Pete Sampras. There's Philippoussis, 19-year-old. Pete Sampras at the other end, the world number one.
Thank you.
Winner of 7 Grand Slam titles.
What do you think, JA, about... do you think this, the roof closed is going to help or hinder Philippoussis?
Well, I would have thought that Pete has had a lot more experience indoors, and so therefore he might feel more comfortable. Generally, perfect conditions favour the higher ranked player. Looking at his racket, it wasn't the cleanest hit, that last forehand. There's a lot of frame in it, putting on a little bit of extra spin to try to make sure of it. But Philippoussis, in going up the line on the backhand, opened up the court to the cross-court forehand, and that's where he got in trouble. The geometry was against him.
Good play. Going back to the roof, being closed, I think it's going to help Philippoussis. I'll tell you why. The reason is that these conditions are going to help his serve. He's got the big serve is always helped by no wind. And Mark is certainly going to need to serve his best to beat the world number one. And if there's no wind and no sun in his eyes, it's going to help.
Game Sampras.
Second love game in this set for Pete Sampras. Well, we heard earlier tonight that Boris Becker will be watching. He also looked ahead to his clash with Brett Stephen in the round of 16.
I have a bad record against him, actually. He's beaten me the last time we played, which was indoors. And I know him quite well, but you know, he seems to be playing very good at the moment. He reached the final last week in his home country, and he's now in the fourth round. And I have to continue playing the way I did today.
So Becker looking ahead to Brett Stephen, both winning today. Mark Philippoussis winning the opening point of this, the fifth game in the second set.
A bit of hesitation there. Mark didn't move in as quickly. And then he played a volley lob almost when the whole line was open. Sampras going wide with the lob.
10 aces, Philippoussis. None so far for Sampras.
There's incredible serving. Serving 10 aces already. I don't know how many unreturnables.
And there's his slider out wide. Slowed down to 176 Ks. Quite an amount of variety. Only 19, but he certainly thinks it out, strategizes very well.
So a couple of love games here for Sampras and then Philippoussis. Nick Bollettieri, happy.
Philippoussis leads 3-2.
Amongst the 15,000 here tonight, been record crowds again today, by the way. They've only missed on one session in the whole week.
15 love.
First ace for Sampras. Philippoussis has 11.
The ace of Philippoussis out wide in the previous game was at 176, as was that slider.
Good change of tactics there. Sampras deciding to come in on his second serve. It's interesting, these two guys have got to the hardest serves in the game, but we're not seeing them serving and volleying because they're so good from the back of the court.
Beautiful tennis from the world's number one. It was a fine first volley and it was an excellent lob from Mark, but Pete was there with the smash and the backup volley.
It's
the first point that Pete's dropped on serve in this set.
First point that's gone against serve for about four games. 40 love, pressure's off a little bit. Pat, you'd have to agree that the longer this set goes without a break in favour of Sampras, the pressure surely increases.
Absolutely. I mean, he's number one player in the world. He's expected to beat this young Australian guy. Philippoussis has got the whole crowd with him.
Against Sampras, you balls, please.
The Philippoussis break came in the 10th game of the opening set.
I think we saw a little bit of that last night as well with Todd Woodbridge and Jim Courier. When it came down to it, to the crunch times, Woodbridge, a lot of the time, most of the time, came out with the goods. That's incredible serving. There is no chance for Pete Sampras to do anything here. He just has to wait his chance and take his opportunity.
Beautiful combination of volleys. A low forehand volley placed within centimetres of the baseline. And then the high angled backhand volley closing out the point. Called attacking the net.
Yeah. He's a sucker for the lob here, but he saw Sampras go for the passing shot and just closed. There's no chance you're going to get past those big arms. A big reach. Well, no harm in serving a double fault this time.
Wait, please. Pick it up, please. Pick it up, please.
I don't know why he's insisting on that, because it was behind the barrier. Nobody could see it. Wasn't going to be a distraction.
Watch Pete Sampras's forehand here. Watch his wrist whip over the top of that.
And Sampras back from 40 love down.
Well, I'd have to say Philippoussis is due for an ace. We're a big serve here. Been pulling them out.
Retrospect, he really should have served and volleyed then. The return of serve went about 2 metres over the net. It would have made for a very easy volley, but locked on the baseline, things were even. Break point. So dangerous when he serves and stays back.
Well, I think he's clearly more confident from the baseline. He feels he can beat Sampras from the baseline. He's out. He's hitting the ball harder. He can get him out of play and then open and just hit the big winner off one of the ground shots. But you're right. If you've got to serve that big, and I think that's what he's coming to terms with over the last year or so, is when to serve volley and when not to serve volley. And clearly, when he picks the days that goes wrong, you can have some strange losses.
The back of the court again. And Martin Mulligan can't believe how hard Mark is hitting the ball from the back of the court. He wasn't too shy from the back of the court himself.
Thank you.
Thank you.
some outstanding hitting from the back of the court. Philippoussis holds. It's 4-3, second set. Sampras 3-4.
15-1.
It's interesting, Pat, that Philippoussis' faster serve is quite a bit quicker than Sampras tonight, but their average on first serve is exactly the same, 188. He is so consistent, the world number one.
I think we'll see over the year, this year, Philippoussis' average going up.
I think part of the reason for that is that Pete Sampras generates pace through rhythm and tempo, and it's a very practiced, relaxed method, whereas Mark often does it with sheer physical strength, and sometimes he just mistimes it, gets one hot, gets one cold every now and again.
49.
He wasn't quite deep enough there.
Just a little bit on the safe side, wasn't it? You could see it was probably 3 or 4 metres inside the sideline. And Pete having another look. This time it's Mark Philippoussis coming back from 40 love down.
We're seeing a few Pete Sampras. I think he's gradually working his way back into the match, but we're still seeing tentative on some of those volleys.
Game Sampras.
Up to 4-all as we were in the opening set. As we check some Nike outside court results, Thomas Enqvist is through to the last 16. He had an easy win today. And he'll play probably Ivanisevic, who's still got to play, though. That match we played tomorrow. Brett Stephen plays Boris Becker. Boris spoke about that earlier. And Barbara Schett will play Anka Huber. She'll beat Elena Sokova, 8-6 in the third.
Good solid volley. Notice how close he gets the net, how far past the service line he gets in. It makes all the difference on the volleys. Notice the difference there. That is the difference. Stefan Edberg, what made him great is how close he got to the net. We'll see here, Mark. It's a good return. Didn't quite get close enough to get that as a low volley. It was a great return.
Pete Sampras all business tonight. He knew he was in for a tough match, and he is raising the level of his game.
He's just starting to try to grab those opportunities, isn't he? Not too many of them.
203 straight down the center. And he's varying his serve so beautifully that there is no way that Sampras can get set. Feel comfortable that the ball is coming one side or the other.
Hey, ball boy.
If you're going to go for an ace, go for one down the middle. It's the shortest way to go. Straight over the lowest part of the net. Shortest distance. Gives the opponent less time to get to.
Wait, please, Mark. Sorry. Thanks.
Thank you.
14-30.
Don't think he hit this exactly where he wanted to, but he got it right into Sampras' backhand. It was so fast, Sampras couldn't get out of the way.
Game
finishes again with an ace, his 14th, and won't Pete have plenty to think about when he goes to sit down? This is the same situation as the opening set. At Flinders Park, Mark Philippoussis took the first set when he broke in this game in the first set. Very similar circumstances. Pete accepts it. That was 205 kilometres per hour.
That was a great passing shot, but that was also great tactics from Mark Philippoussis. We've seen him come into the net, chip charge, only in two games. And that was, what a great underneath and over the top of that one. And that was the game that he broke last set, putting pressure on the number one in the world.
And what it does is put pressure on Pete to get the first serve in, which in turn might encourage him to slow it down a little bit. You've got to admire Pete Sampras. He's going for his shots under some real pressure. Some tension there, certainly, being at a set down and 4-5, serving to stay in the second set. And the second serve wayward. His first serve percentage dropping now to 56%. Second serve almost up with Mark Philippoussis at 161 on that last point.
Game Sampras.
Impressive, wasn't he? The champ holds to love. 5-5.
Five games
Nick Bollettieri had some interesting things to say today to you, Bruce, during your interview, that he didn't really expect Mark to win today. He said he had a couple more years of development before he'd be reaching his full potential, and that Andre and Pete had had a number of more years on the tour. He's such a shrewd operator and coach. He effectively took all the pressure off Mark Philippoussis and the high expectations that been discussed.
Love 15.
It's a bit of pressure on Mark here, but you're absolutely right. The last thing you want, you've got all the pressure from the media, everything, everybody else, to be one of the best players in the world. You don't want your coach putting pressure on you too.
15.
He also spoke very warmly of Nick Philippoussis, Mark's father, and how they're working together.
Fifteen aces for Philippoussis.
Got to keep upgrading their statistics after virtually every other point.
Well, I think Pete Sampras is getting back what he's given out for so many years.
That's exactly right, and he doesn't like playing big servers.
Who does?
Outstanding for the Philippoussis. Ace. It's 6-5. Welcome back. As the crowd are right into this match, as you'd expect. Most important time now. Pivotal moment, really. At 5-6 second set, Pete Sampras already a set behind. And serving second in this set, Mark Philippoussis, 17 aces. He's in outstanding form.
that's the play that Pete Sampras doesn't want to see. He hasn't got to hit a lot of balls so far tonight. He'll be asked to make difficult passing shots to hang on to his serve at this stage. Would be a tough act.
Well, that was a very uncharacteristic miss there, Sampras. It was quite easy backhand. It was a winner there, clear winner. He's tense.
He tried to nurse it in.
He's definitely tense.
Nice to know he's human. That's precisely the right tactic from Mark Philippoussis. Bunt the ball over, get it over, do anything, get into the net and ask the question. 6'4", great coverage at the net. It's an intimidating sight. And Sampras is under some real pressure now. 15-30.
Boy, he was taking a risk there, wasn't he?
Yes, let's have another look at this. The jump smash from the service line coming to the net. Not the easiest shot because you really practice a smash as you're coming to the net.
Well, a bit of luck here from Philippoussis. A mishit forehand lob over the backhand side, as it was said before. Those backhand smashes are the toughest shot in the game.
Thank you.
Brings up set point. Watch these tactics. Oh. As calm as you like.
Dad looks proud and very happy.
It's a great second serve. A great forehand to follow it up.
Fearless on the forehand. Smashed that, then thought maybe it's going out, maybe I can't quite reach it. Or cleared the baseline. For the second time.
That was the right play. Say to the number one player in the world, try and pass me. I'm 6'4", I got a huge reach and a good volley. He had to hit a shot like that to win the point.
So Mark was at full reach and it only just got the edge of the frame. He wasn't far off being able to make a volley. At deuce, 5-6.
Into the tie break. And world number one
answering the challenge.
Great tennis under real pressure. Number one player for the last 3 years. And he is playing at his full potential at the moment and locked in battle.
Philippoussis took the tiebreak of the US Open 7-5 in their only clash to date. And Sampras had real trouble in tiebreaks at this tournament last year. He lost one to Larson, two to Courier, one to Chang and one to Agassi. And he only lost six for the year, and they were here and at the US Open. Surface on hard court.
Well, that's a great forehand passage. I think one of the reasons for that is that, of course, the player's come off a break. Look at that, he got around the outside there. Just wasn't quite wide enough. Because the player's come off a break over Christmas time, they're not quite as tough as they normally are, the top players.
2-0.
It's got a good start here.
Service point down, but the pressure is on Mark now to win both of these points. Otherwise, he will be in serious trouble. Seizing the opportunity to be aggressive. Beautiful combination of approach and volley.
3-2.
And the pressure is on Sampras to hold both points on serve.
A great time for an ace.
It's an incredible count too, Pat. 18-1 in favour of the Australian.
Spending most of the night shaking my head in disbelief. They're like lack of footwork there.
4-2.
Football probably jumped slightly more. Well, a change of ends here. Got to go down, towel down, have a little sip. Sip of water, whatever. Try and relax. But then when you come down here, the whole time you're really thinking, well, where am I going to serve, where am I going to serve? Sometimes it's sort of like walking up to make a big putt in golf. It's like sometimes there's too much time to think.
Silana Molkai, Pete's girlfriend.
Backhand, measured it, took his time. This is a study on exactly how to hit a backhand. A classic looking shot, early preparation, comfortably inside the lines.
5-4.
Sampras has to win both points to wrap up the set. He knows that Ron Mark will go for the return.
Perfect.
What an amazing forehand. He had to hit the winner.
No half measure.
He knew this wasn't coming back either.
For a metre and a half behind the baseline, the second set is tied up. 5 points all in the tiebreaker.
6-5, Sampras. Set point for Sampras.
Charging to the net after that forehand. Looks confident. 6 points all. Extraordinary composure for a 19-year-old playing against the world's best player, who is in peak form. And Sampras can only watch the winners go by. Points away from a two-set to love lead.
Oh, boy, that was close.
Set point.
It's his third set point. Had a couple on Sampras's service game in the 12th game of the set.
It's a great serve. Setting up what could have been a very tricky shot. If Philippoussis has stood his ground, he certainly would have made Sampras think. Now that certainly tested Pete Sampras. The return clipped the top of the net, made it awfully difficult for him. Just changes that height slightly, but he hit it perfectly in the corner and set up the smash.
Just the highest quality tennis, isn't it?
They're not doing any mistakes. They're hitting the ball hard and in the corners. Does not get any better than this.
Tactically, they're brave and sound.
Braver than me, that's for sure.
Well, my hands are sweating. I've got goosebumps. How are you travelling, Pat? Set point again for Philippoussis.
All right, it's sort of slightly weird for me to watch a tennis match like this.
I've got to tell you back home that Pat's been standing up for a half an hour. He refuses to sit down. He's on the edge of his seat.
It's very exciting tennis.
Thank you.
Oh, Jesus. A little bit awkward.
Thank you.
Appeared that Sampras followed through into the ground then.
9.
Mark has got to make a few of those. He's always going for his shots, and that is definitely strength. On a big occasion like that, when he's set point, he wants to make a few of those, like get them back into play.
Sampras changing his racket. In the previous serve, it appeared he followed through and hit the ground rather solidly. He's just debating. This time last year, he had terrible problems with the string tensions. He had a record number of rackets strung throughout the tournament. It was very, very hot, and it appeared that the heat was softening the strings. He was getting a trampolining effect and losing control.
I think it's a very brave move, changing your racket. Yeah. Just as we talked about.
Now set point on the Philippoussis serve. Beautiful low return, setting up the chance to make the pass.
Thank you.
He's done it. And the man they call the Scud leads by 2 sets to 0. Welcome back. As we rejoin you at Flinders Park, Mark Philippoussis, the 19-year-old, leads Pete Sampras by 2 sets to 0. This is Mark's reaction after he took the second set, 11-9 in the tiebreak. It's been a magnificent match so far. Sampras to serve. Had just one break of serve in the match. It was in the 10th game of the opening set. And that is Pete Sampras's second ace only. Philippoussis has served 20. Opening game, third set. Sampras came from 2 sets to 0 down twice last year, once against Magnus Larsson on a Sunday afternoon and against Jim Courier on a Tuesday night.
Yep, there's still a long way to go.
Close.
13. The tough thing when you're playing is the guy who's serving so big is you do not get a chance to get any rhythm. One ball's an ace. Next time you might have is the only chance you get.
Sampras's power on the first serve dropped right then down to 154. He remained back and played rather tentatively. I'll give you some idea how much he dislikes playing big servers against Ivanisevic in the semi-finals at Wimbledon 1992. 6-7, 7-6, and then went down 4-2 and put up relatively little resistance after the second set. And again, questioning the call, but it appeared to be correct.
Holds in the opening game of this third set. Philippoussis leads 2 sets to 0. That's the shot on the concourse outside. Some people milling around, trying to look at a television set. Getting into this match, Sampras trails 2 sets to 0 against Philippoussis. Hasn't been able to break Mark's serve tonight. It's got close.
Pete Sampras has only been in the country a little bit over a week, and that's a sight you normally only see during the finals when all the ball boys and the ball girls sit on the side of the court. It's Moving very, very well. He gets to this in plenty of time and plays a good shot, just catching the top of the net. Consistent power on the second serve has been astonishing.
It's big time to come out with a big serve, second serve, that pace.
Under pressure, world's number one chipping and charging down the line. He's taken his time, he's made his choice to go across court and then executed to perfection.
One game ball, third set.
One game ball.
Tennis Australia hope you're enjoying the first Grand Slam of the year, the 1996 Ford Australian Open.
Tony Roach and John Newcombe, the coach and captain of the Australian Davis Cup team. That's a good sign for Philippoussis. 15-30, second serve, a double fault there and still able to hold.
Sampras' footwork is not good at the moment.
That was just a little careless from Pete. Tough low volley, did the right thing, and with the difficult low forehand volley, went for something you might try when you're leading 40 love. Love 30.
15-14. Two break points for Mark Philippoussis.
Was a very good second serve, a lot of spin there. I think he knew that Philippoussis was going to come in. Had to hit the good second serve.
Please.
It's a little bit unlucky there from Mark. Just set the ball up there. It's a good defensive lob, not, maybe not quite deep enough. Mobile phone.
Shoot that man.
Why, thank you.
Obviously doesn't know there's a scud and a pistol on the court.
White, please. Thank you.
It appears he's too embarrassed to answer it. There's Darren Hinch when you need him. Shame, shame, shame.
Juice.
Advantage. Sampras.
Very close.
Game Sampras.
A couple of aces in a row. Holds.
Sampras leads. Two games.
Looking through the outside courts to the Melbourne City on this Saturday night, on a day where the temperature dropped from about 25 to 14 in half an hour. Record crowd today, 21,019, a record for a first Saturday. And tonight is an official sellout, so it's a combined record as well. It's been a magnificent match so far, and an absolutely brilliant start for the young Australian. He's two sets to love in front.
It's interesting that Mark's getting away with that, because he has gone across court virtually every single time on his backhand passing shot. You would think that Pete would be sitting on it by now.
I think you just had too much time then.
Still being beaten. Certainly had a lot of time.
13.
Seeing Sampras still being very tentative. Let me see Mark Philippoussis reaching up, left hand up high.
14.
The ace count up to 22 now. Sampras with a couple in the previous game on 4. Quickly add to that, 200 k's an hour, right down the middle. How's that? Ace, ace.
Well, that's just incredible serving. See, watch his left hand. That's when he's throwing the ball up there, he keeps his left hand up. It gives him a bit of a seesaw action. Get your left hand up when you're throwing the ball. Your right arm is going to come up very high and get a lot of great reach.
15.
What I find incredible is that his form coming into this hasn't been very, all that great. He's playing unbelievable tonight.
It was interesting, Pat, because Mark played an 18-year-old qualifier who was playing in his very first Grand Slam, and a lucky loser who had no form at all. They were his first two matches, and then had to play the number one.
One word, mate, pressure. Lack of it tonight, a lot of thin.
Pat, what you're saying is that there's no pressure on Philippoussis tonight.
Yeah, well, he's
that he is not expected to win.
Yeah, exactly. You know, we talked about what Nick Bollettieri said. I think the crowd and most Australians want him to win, but you know, he doesn't really expect to win, and he's going for his shots, and they're coming off.
Game Sampras.
Love game to Sampras. So a couple of love games in a row there.
Sampras leads.
It's 3-2, third set. Welcome back to our live and exclusive coverage of this third round match between Pete Sampras and Mark Philippoussis. Scorelines are beauty for the Australian.
15.
Good change of pace there on that serve. 157 k's.
Game 15 all.
Yeah, ball toss was a little low. Didn't even get his get into the right position there. He served. He didn't get his back foot up to throw. Ball toss is the all important thing in the serve.
He's obviously thinking he's gone across court a great many times off the backhand, and this time straight down the line, beating Pete by a good meter.
14.
Leading in most categories, including the backhand winners. And on the aces, it's up to nearly a quarter of a century. 24-4.
Game for the Philippoussis.
I told you, John, you got to count quickly, don't you? He has finished so many games with an ace, and on a number of occasions with ace-ace, and on two with ace-ace-ace. It's been the most impressive display. Long way to go yet.
If he could take this form to the casino, he'd be a very wealthy man. Which means he'd probably lose some money, and he'd still be very wealthy.
I'll work all that out later, John. It's 3-all. Third set.
Again, down the line, had Sampras beaten.
It's good play there. He's just trying to get the ball back. He knows the Sampras serve is big. He's chipping it back, getting it low. Pete Sampras is not, hasn't got any stick at all in his volleys tonight. So stick, I mean pace. It's tennis lingo, isn't it, that, Jay? Stick. Not like Michael Stick.
Yes, he's
stick to beat
he's
with.
Volleying isn't the best part of his game.
That is just blistering pace. Just phenomenal pace. He got a fraction more time. Just had a fraction more time to wind up there. Well, wasn't even that short.
He is amongst the biggest hitters of all time.
There's a chance here, isn't it? 15-30.
Sampras actually looked intimidated when he went to serve. When the ball came back, visibly shaken.
It was a tricky shot there, Mark, just slicing it back again. That ball slid off the court. Sampras didn't get underneath it. You guessed right.
He's varying his play so well. A topspin forehand lob. He hadn't tried one all match. It wasn't a bad shot, but Sampras just got there in the high defensive lob from the other end, getting a good look at it. It would have been a winner against most people, but Mark's anticipation has been phenomenal tonight. 30 all. And again, he picks the sliding serve.
13-14.
And achieves break point. 3-all in the third set. Two sets to love up.
And the champ looked to the heavens then, wondering.
Deuce.
Ooh, that was very close, wasn't it? What's to do is just touch that centre line, on any line, and it's in.
Two great serves by Sampras. One an ace, one almost unplayable. Saving off the break point. He holds Sampras. It's 4-3, third set. And inside with Mark Philippoussis serving. It's two sets to love.
For all his aggression, that's probably the wildest shot he's played all night. Difficult return, mishit angle from Pete Sampras. It's like a gorilla with a big stick sort of swatting away a fly that's annoying him when he gets down a point, just comes up with the ace.
Sampras is not really making any inroads here in a Philippoussis serve. He's flat on his feet. You really have to get more aggressive.
Points on Philippoussis' serve in this set. Two of them were double faults, and one was that mishit or overhit at the start of this game.
And Mark is not doing anything wrong. He's serving big. It shots like this as well from right in the back of the court.
He has played magnificently from the opening point. As he did this time last year in his opening round against Stefan Edberg, who was then, I think, the seventh best player in the world.
Nike outside court result. Mark Woodford beat Francisco Clavet in four sets and will play the winner of this match in the round of 16. We may have an All-Australian fourth round, which means we'd have a quarter-finalist. And off the top, I guess you're the last Australian to get that far.
Wally Miss,
Wally.
Possibly. And Pat Cash.
No, Pat.
Pat who? Pat Cash.
15 love.
What Philippoussis is doing fantastically well, as we see in this point, is that he can get the ball down low on some of these returns.
He just reached for his back then, and he did have a back problem late last year.
I have back problems, and I don't serve at 207 miles an hour all the time. You're going to pick me up on that one, aren't you, Jay? K's an hour. Yeah, living in London too much.
I've got an answer for everything, Cashy.
Yeah, it's 207 miles an hour.
Doesn't suit you.
No, didn't think so.
I just can't change those calls. No.
Quite a direct confrontation there.
Neither he should. Oh, first of all, it was out. Second of all, it was the furthest corner of the court.
Oh! 40-15.
It's a dangerous thing to say, isn't it? But, Pete, you feel just doesn't know how to get out at the moment. He's not dispirited, but a bit hangdog. He's got the best temperament in the game in the last two or three years, but
still a long way to go.
He's just trying to find a way through, and it's very difficult.
Well, I think he's doing everything in his power. He's playing very, very well. It's just to this
14-30.
Point. Mark Philippoussis has played a little bit better.
A lot better.
Well, 6-4, 7-6, sort of close still.
Yeah, it's two sets of love.
Game Sampras.
The old Sampras. He's 5-4. In this the third set. Well, what a moment now with Mark Philippoussis.
Thank you.
4-5. Sampras hasn't been able to break all night. He's two sets to love down, the world number one.
15 love.
27 aces for Philippoussis. Make that 28. Been a remarkable serving performance, sustained.
It's not just serving, his backhand has been magnificent, his forehand, his volleying. He's even displayed some very fine touch from time to time.
Well, I think we see Pete Sampras is just waiting for Mark Philippoussis to make some mistakes, but he's not making them at all.
14.
I think Mark has broken the machine because that just registered 177, and that's a mistake. I've often had a debate with an officer about things like that. Your gun's all wrong.
My car doesn't go that fast. That's another good one.
It's a big second serve. It's a 168.
It's a game of absolute confidence, assurance.
5 games all.
If you were watching this match as a stranger to the game, you'd say that Philippoussis was the world's champion. He's playing with such confidence.
Five, please. Thank you.
5-all, third set.
Please.
There was going in, Mark. He was looking. 15. Sure, I'd hit that. You need to hit that. Good tactics again. Put the pressure on the guy. Lazy shot, wasn't it?
Well, you've just got to remember that Pete Sampras outlasted the great Jim Courier this time last year. And Courier went 4.5 hours undiminished last night. Horrible luck, that ball hitting the top of the net, and really set it up for Pete Sampras. Generally you think a let cord is a lucky shot, but not in this case. It stopped the ball in its tracks and Sampras was able to turn it around and go on the attack. It's one of the few times that Mark Philippoussis has guessed wrong.
Sampras, 6 games to 5.
Well, wait, the next 5 minutes tell a tale here. At 5-6, Philippoussis serving.
Yeah, Jane and I were saying, I tell you what, Mark wants to get this set. Why, you can let the world number one in. Two sets to one. We reckon it's about 50-50 after that.
And he'll know that Sampras did the trick twice here last year from two sets to love down.
Two.
a great start for Philippoussis. Off forehand winner.
Must be a bit of a sinking feeling for Pete to realise that his only real chance of getting this set is going to be in a tiebreaker. At this moment, he certainly doesn't look like breaking.
Well, if we went to a tiebreaker, you'd have to fancy Philippoussis. He's getting so many free points from his serve.
Thank you.
In with just not doing quite enough on this last volley. Let's watch it in replay. Sampras flat out to get the ball back. A magnificent backhand. And at the full stretch, maybe the Sampras's ball was going out. 40-15.
204 straight down the centre. 30 aces, Philippoussis.
6 games of third set time.
Well, here we go.
Right, please. Thank you. Players are ready. Thank you.
And that's the tactic that Mark Philippoussis has employed all evening.
1-0.
Attacking the second serve of Sampras and following it to the net. And he is now in the driver's seat. Martin Nottingham looks like he's over the finish line. 5 points to go. Has the wonderful opportunity of getting one further break point up over the next two, which would just about seal it. Just one service point advantage at the moment.
Thank you.
Oh, very tentative volley there from Sampras. He did not want to make a mistake there. He's saying is I'll let Philippoussis hang himself.
Had that ball just gone over the net. I think it was just about going in. 1-3. Position now for Mark Philippoussis.
Thank you.
Against the world's best player.
He has not made a mistake all night.
I thought that he just played the slightest bit safer on that past point. But he got away with it.
I'm not surprised.
He's got to be feeling extraordinary things at this moment. Something he's worked towards all of his young
Ladies
life.
Ladies and gentlemen, quiet please.
5 points to one. One more point on serve.
Quiet please. Thank you.
He is nerveless, and now with surely an insurmountable lead, match points.
Philippoussis.
The expectations of a nation.
Players are ready. Thank you. Quiet,
Mark
please.
Philippoussis appears to be delivering.
6-2. Philippoussis. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you. Thank you. Quiet, please. Thank you.
Sampras not giving up without giving his all.
Thank you. Quiet, please. Thank you. Quiet, please. Thank you. Game.
A sportsman and a gentleman, the world's number one player, the dominant player in world tennis for the last 3 years, leaves the court a victim of the 19-year-old sensation from Melbourne, Mark Philippoussis, the winner in straight sets in 2 hours and 14 minutes. 6-4, 7-6, 7-6.